Sacramento's Stanford was no threat on Thursday night to replicate the victory over number 14 Kansas that two of its Pac-12 conference rivals achieved earlier this month. Get Pac-12 conference news in your inbox with the Pac-12 Hotline newsletter. Sign up. The Jayhawks, smarting after losses to Washington and Arizona State, dominated from the start and ended their Pac-12 drought with a 75-54 victory at the Golden One Center. Second-year coach Jared Haas lost to his alma mater for the second straight season as the Cardinal 6-7 dropped to 0-11 against top 25 teams the past 2 years. Haas may have overscheduled this season, given earlier Cardinal losses by a combined 53 points to North Carolina, Florida, and Ohio State. This was no better. Stanford shot just 34%, scored a season-low point total, and never got closer than 14 points in the second half. Certainly disappointment with this game, Haas said. If you ask me in a few days, I'm going to be of optimism. Stanford opens Pac-12 play on December 30th at home against Cal. The Cardinal could not contain the 13-time defending Big 12 champion Jayhawks 10-2, who made 8 dunks and 6 three-pointers in the first half while forging a 47-29 lead. KU shot 63% in the first half to the delight of a strong KU fan contingent among the announced crowd of 7,880. Shout out to Jayhawk Nation, guard Devontae Graham said. It was like a semi-home game for us. Those in red and blue cheered loudest for Idoka Azubike, KU's 7-foot, 280-pound sophomore center, who scored his team's first 10 points, all of them on shots inside 2 feet. Azubike made 9 of his first 10 attempts on the way to scoring 24 points. He dunked 7 times, pushing his season total to 49, and is shooting 77.9% through 12 games. He's a huge guy, so it's tough, said center Michael Humphrey, who scored 20 points but was often left alone to defend Azubike as Stanford opted against sagging off perimeter shooters. Cardinal star Reed Travis, who scored 29 points against the Jayhawks last season, largely was held in check. The Pac-12's top scorer at 22.2 points per game, he was limited to a season-low 12. They did a good job of trying to deny catches and trying to send a defender to help out, Travis said. But that's something I've faced all year. I was a little disappointed in myself. Ha said he's still not sure when starting guards Dorian Pickens and Marcus Sheffield, both sidelined by left foot injuries, might be ready to play. Pickens has missed the past 11 games, Sheffield the entire season so far. But the Cardinal welcomed freshman forward Kezia Kpale, finally academically cleared after sitting out the team's first 12 games. A consensus top 50 prospect from Esperanto High in Los Angeles, Opcala played 28 minutes off the bench and scored 6 points on 2-for-8 shooting. I was really proud of the way he competed, Haas said. We're excited for big things moving forward from him. Stanford led 11-10 after a 3-pointer by Humphrey with 15-18 left in the first half. But the Jayhawks responded with an 18-2 run over the next 5 minutes, zooming into a 28-13 lead. The margin reached 31-15 after a 3-pointer by Graham, asterisk Haas, who started 99 games and 3 seasons at KU after playing his freshman season alongside Jason Kidd at Cal, will take his team back to Lawrence, Kansas, again next December 1st, then complete the 4-year series at Maples Pavilion on December 29, 2019. Asterisk Sacramento Kings rookie Frank Mason III, the national player of the year last season at Kansas, was shown on the arena big screen early in the first half, drawing a huge ovation from the strong contingent of Jayhawks fans.